But why do you love Destiny so much, Kyle? What about it speaks to you as a human being and your need to grind?
Man, that's a great question, because I hate it most of the time. Which I think
isn't that like a Destiny fan thing though? Yeah. Like that's even me. I'm like, I love Destiny, I have it tattooed on my body, but I don't like it.
it is kind of a requirement. For me, the biggest reason, honestly, is, and I've talked about this before with a lot of people, like, I play games predominantly for the people that I play games with. Like, I'll play pretty much anything if I've got other friends playing it. I will try any game, I will check out anything if there's other people playing it, just because I like to play things with other people, because I usually am just kind of hanging out here by myself, and most of my friends are virtual friends, and so it's like, hey, cool, let's find things to play. So Destiny is one that, like, I got in with a group, and I've got a really good group of people that I play with that we've all become like really good friends outside of just in the game. So that's mm-hmm. that's kind of like the biggest reason that I continue to play it a lot. But it is also like, despite all of the things that Bungie continues to do, including the transmog thing that they just announced,
so
that they
bad.
Managed to they managed to take the thing everyone's complained about for years, which is that, oh, it's bounty grind the game, and they made it more bounty grind the game. But they, like, I look at all those things and I get mad, but then I also go, but man, this gunplay, no game feels this good.
What platform do you play on?
PC.
That hand cannon is nasty on PC.
I'm very bad at PvP things, but I've gotten better. But getting used to like shotguns and hand cannons and things like that, like, because I started playing on PlayStation. I played on PS4 for mm-hmm. D1. And then for the first like year of D2, and then I had maybe a little bit less. So I had quit when Curse of Osiris had come out, and then didn't come back. I came back with Shadowkeep, came back on PC, and that's when I really got, like, I had like 60 hours total, and now I have like 1500. So, and all that's come, most it's all come since, you know, Shadowkeep. But it's, yeah, that, like, on console, I was using like terribly optimized loadouts, but I was just using scout rifles and auto rifles, because I was like, oh, I like these, cool. And now I'm like, oh, I've got to learn other things and get better. But it is fun. I have more complaints than I do good things to say about it. But it's still just like, I love the raids. I love the music in the raid. Like, the new raid that came out last November, we did it. We did day one, which was really fun, and got that completed.
Nice.
And the music in that is just, I mean, like, I bought the soundtrack, and sometimes we'll play it when I'm in the car, just sitting at my desk. And it's,
you probably like Destiny the same reason that I do, and I don't play it much anymore, but I still love Destiny for the fact that it's a game where my favorite memories were in junior college playing doubles, doing the Valentine's Day doubles with my roommate, where she moved her console and her TV out of her room to play in the same room as me. Or getting together with like people online to do the raid and like dancing in circles in the middle of the tower. Like, just like that feeling of just coming together with like a bunch of people that you don't know at first, and then like becoming like such amazing friends with them later. And with Destiny 2, I was the same thing as you. I quit when Curse of Osiris came out, because I'm like, this is just not fun and it sucks, because I love Destiny. And then I kind of jumped back when Forsaken came out, for obviously I jumped back, and I played for like a while after that. And I'm getting all my lore knowledge through you now, because Destiny's still doing such amazing lore things to me. But it's just like the gameplay, I can't, like, I'll play it, and then I remembered why I didn't play it for so long, was because I'm like, yes, I'm terrible, and I play games where you're doing the same thing over and over. But with Destiny, yeah, the gunplay is good, but there's just so much that I could do the same strike over and over.
Yeah.
I think for me, Destiny would totally like still be my thing if I was back in like my multiplayer playing like prime days, back when like Halo 3 first came out. But social anxiety being what it is, conducive to making friends online. I guess except for like maybe the last 8 months or so. But yeah, I played the crap out of Destiny 1 when it first came out, had a little group of friends, did all the raids, maybe not necessarily day one like the champ here. But yeah, it was fun. And every time I haven't played it on PC in like, I want to say like a year at this point, but every once in a while I still reconsider doing it purely just because the gameplay is just freaking top notch, especially on PC. But like the only thing keeping me back is that every time I jump in, there's like a million new resources and new little minor quests. And I'm just like, oh no, I don't like the grind part. I just want to shoot the dudes.
Yeah, that's like Sarah said, like for me, the big things that like my best memories or the things that I like the most about Destiny are all experiences I've had with people and not specific things that I've done. Like we've got a bunch of inside jokes for different things, and mm-hmm. we have different memories that we have of doing things and some fun times that we've had, even all the way back to D1, my very first raid that I did with some friends that I knew in person. And one of the guys in the group that I didn't know, though, called me Kevin. And so the guy leading the group, who was a good friend of mine, just decided to roll with it because I didn't say anything, because I'm like, I don't know you guys. I've never done this. You're teaching me. I don't want you to whatever. I just want to do this. And so they just kept calling. So my buddy keeps calling me Kevin. So for about a year and a half, the other people that didn't know me swore that my name was Kevin. So when I was interacting in the Facebook group that we had, they thought I was someone completely different. And they were wondering who this Kevin, like, because the Kevin guy was never around in the group. He was just playing, but I was always around in the group and never playing. And then finally they eventually like I just assumed they all knew, and so did my buddy. And then we just kind of realized, oh no, they didn't realize. But so now I've got like a completely different group here that I play with now, and it's great. And we do, like I said, we've got some guys who love to. We did Deepstone Crypt 3-man at one point, which was really fun. We play trials, which I'm terrible at. People carry me, and I just drink a lot and do terrible at it, which is super fun. But it's just fun, and like it is fun to play. It's not fun. I don't enjoy the grind. There are people I know that do enjoy the grind, but the actual gameplay is really fun, and there is good content. I think this season was better than most of the last few seasons have been, and I think up until this transmog thing, they had been really moving in the right direction. It's like, hey, you're actually making good decisions. You're doing things that I like. And then announce that, which I'm sure they'll end up walking back at some point. But I would say if there's a time to try to get back into it, I would say now is probably not a bad time.
Yeah, I was just talking to my friend about this. I said I was playing something, and it reminded me of when the loot cave first happened.
That was a beautiful time.
Those were some of my favorite moments in Destiny, because if I remember, you needed 4 people to get the loot cave to work. So you would just find 3 random people standing there who didn't know each other, who would just emote, like wave at each other, because they all knew that they were there for the same thing. And I would just spend 5 hours just with these 3 random ass people just shooting into this cave the whole time.
Wait, do you guys
leaving and just waving and then going off array? But I did want to bring up, I remember when the Vault of Glass came up, because that was my favorite Destiny meme ever, where you would play. I remember I did the Vault of Glass till 3 in the morning, like the day it came out. I beat it, and all I got was a stupid shader, and it became a meme between me and all of my friends. To where someone's like, what did you get? I got a shader. As everyone just gets a gun, or like everyone gets like a really cool armor piece. And it's like, Sarah, what'd you get? And I just remember I was so exhausted. And I just went, I can turn my armor purple. And everyone's
at
like,
at least you'll look cool.
It wasn't even a good looking purple. That's what I was talking about it. And it's just like, that's my favorite parts of Destiny, is the stuff like that happening. Or when, I mean, this isn't really a spoiler, or when Cade 6 died, and outside of E3 that year, people built that little shrine that had instant Robin in front of it, and someone had put Cade's picture in a frame, and someone had put a plush chicken on there. Like, just the community to me is literally my all-time favorite part of Destiny. And like Kyle mentioned earlier, people who like Destiny, you also don't like Destiny. Like, oh, it's, yeah, like it's sort of like a thing. You have to say, oh yeah, Destiny's great. Yes, I have a Destiny tattoo. Warlocks are great, but I hate it.
I feel like that love-hate relationship is like so central to the Destiny experience. Like, everyone knows that feeling.
Well, because the game has always had those ebbs and flows of it's really, really great, and then it goes back down again.
I remember back in Destiny. I remember back in Destiny 1 where I don't know, this is like maybe the first couple months where you just had to grind for materials before you could even really get into stuff. I don't remember what the exact stuff was, but it kind of resulted in just like going on patrols across the map, just like finding little treasure boxes to get those specific materials. I'm like, I need to do that for like 8 hours before I can be strong enough to do the raid.
That was the worst.
It was a bad time.
Getting strong enough to do the raid, and then the raid's like, here's some like indestructible eyeballs that cannot look at you, or else it starts a 20-second timer to when everybody dies, and it's like, just make a break for it. Everybody just run. Like, we can make it there in under 20 seconds if we just run. Like, God, that was, oh my God, just all the memories are just coming back to doing the raids at like 2 a.m. and just being like, I've done it. I can never do it again. Like, I never have to do this again. And just getting that trophy and then like showing it off to like all your friends, like, I beat the raid. Everyone's like, no. God, those were the days, man.
One last question before we move on to the news. And this is a very important question. And Mesa, have you played Destiny?
Not really. I've only vaguely touched it once or twice.
Okay, you're still obligated to answer this as well. Because I know Sarah and I are in agreement about this. Kyle, what class do you main?
Hunter.
Boo.
I forget what the classes are, but the...
I'm a warlock main man, let's go!
Warlock, yeah,
Sarah, that's it. Sarah, dab with me.
Let's go. Also, I feel like I can never escape it. Bad spring break tattoo choice, man. Was just like, let's get the Destiny symbol. The class I have 1,000 hours.
Yeah, that's dope. I wouldn't.
I will say though, this season I've not played as much, so it's been different. But every other season I play all three. Hunter was like the one I've played the most because it's the one I started with. But I would play all three every week, do all my pinnacles, do the raid every, you know, three times, whatever, and do all that. So I do play all of them, and I'm competent on all of them, although Baconator in chat and anybody I play with will tell you I can't jump on anything that's not a hunter. The running joke is if we do a raid that has like any jumping segment, like when we do Deepstone Crypt, there's a section midway through where if I'm not on my hunter, I will go to orbit and I will wait for them to get through it, because otherwise I'm just dying over and over and over again, and it's so frustrating because I'm terrible at it. And I just get like, I'll get hit by something and I can't correct, or I overcorrect, and it's awful.
I feel like once you've played a game for like so long, you get so used to like every little tiny detail of like how they move and how they interact with the world, that when you even slightly change that, everything just feels off, and it's...
Mm-hmm.
Titan jumps are gross, I'll say that.
Titans are the worst chads ever, and I will not take the statement back.
Actually, you know what? I think I posted on Twitter or something. Hunters jump, warlocks glide, and titans yeet.
Hey man, warlocks finally got a wizard staff this last X-Pack. Took them long enough. Like, we've been face wizards this whole time, and the game's like, you want sword? It's like, no! How this works? Like, you want fire sword? It's like, no, this isn't. I mean, it's cool, and I can res myself.
But it's cool, I'll take it, but...
Yeah, but that's not a wizard staff. And then the game's like, fine, you get a wizard staff, but it's for the darkness subclass. And I'm like, fire wizard staff? I'm like, please? Plus, all I mean, right. The one thing I think Destiny's missing really quick is I think they're missing support classes, but that's just my own personal opinion, because they're an MMO, but...
Like, I will say... I was pretty sad when they took away the resurrect from warlocks from D1 to D2.
Oh, I was so pissed. I mean, technically, if you're a fire warlock, one of your abilities is you can do that awesome, like, self-res yourself. And the memories that I have of scaring the shit out of people in the Crucible, of just resing myself directly in front of them, just watching them, like, scramble, is so much fun.
This will literally be the last thing I say, but I love doing that in Destiny 1. If you use the, I forget what they're called, the sticky grenades, because it just gave you unlimited of them, and you're just tossing them in every tiny little corner, and it's just a massacre, and I loved it.